It is day four from the 28th Winter Universiade here in Almaty, Kazakhstan. Some beautiful snow has fallen over the last couple days, and it's led to great action. Today, we'll take a look at alpine skiing, the men's alpine combined event. Following that, we'll head to Medeu for speed skating. It'll be the men's 500 meters. The Nordic combined individual Gundersen for men took place today, as well as ski jumping. It's the normal hill for women. At Almaty Arena, figure skating competition is underway with the ladies' short program. From the Shymbalek Ski Resort just outside of Almaty, it is the men's alpine combined. -8 degrees up at the top of the mountain. Lots of snow and fog over the last couple days, but it's cleared enough today that we can get this competition underway. We'll start with the Super G, and it'll be followed by the slalom. First up, Matej Falat of Slovakia. He did not finish in the Super G competition here in Almaty on day two, but he did win a silver in the slalom and a bronze in the Super Combined at Universiade in Granada back in 2015. And there you see Follett cross the line in a time of 1:08.65 to set that early pace. Now Michelangelo Tentori of Italy. He won his second straight Super G gold medal here at Universiade earlier in the games. Second racer down the course, trying to catch Falat of Slovakia. And there you see him at the line, just over a second ahead to move into top spot. Now Martin Meiners of the Netherlands. Fifth in an FIS Alpine combined race in Austria back in December. Looking well down the course here at Shymbalek. Good view there of the finish area. Trying to beat Tentori. And Miners will not quite do it, about a half second back, currently in third spot. Now Kristaps Zvenieks of Latvia. He was the Latvian flag bearer in the opening ceremonies back on Sunday. He's a two-time Olympian, competed in Vancouver in 2010 and again in Sochi in 2014. It's also his second Universiade, having competed in Trentino back in 2013. Trying to catch Tentori, and he will do it. 22 one-hundredths ahead of the Italian. And Zvenieks is in first spot. Now of Jenny Piasek of Russia. Trying to catch the Latvian. Round those final gates and to the line. No, close though, 7 one-hundredths back. He's in second spot. And there you see the standings after the Super G portion of this Alpine combined. Now switch to the slalom. Here is Fala. Ended up in 12th after the Super G. Now trying to catch Narita of Japan. And at the interval, 34 one-hundredths ahead. Followed also a former Olympian, skied at Sochi in 2014. And he'll move into top spot. 79 one-hundredths ahead of Narita. Now Martin Meiners was at Trentino for Universiade in 2013, had fourth and fifth place finishes in competitions there. He was 10th after the Super G today. Trying to catch Falat. And he does it, 13 one-hundredths ahead of the Slovakian. He's currently in top spot. Now Zvenieks. the leader after the Super G. Trying to put down a good race here in the slalom. Give himself a great shot at gold. Had a much better race in the Super G today. He was 14th in the Super G competition earlier in the games. And Zvenics will catch Miners almost a second ahead of him to move into first place. And he's thrilled. Competitors cheering him on, and Kristaps Zvenics of Latvia wins the gold medal in the men's Alpine combined. Martin Miners just behind him in second spot, and Matej Falat of Slovakia wins the bronze medal. From the Medeu Sports Complex just outside of Almaty, a beautiful setting for speed skating. This is the men's 500 meters, race one of two. Look at Zhang Hongqiang of China and Kim Young-jin of Korea. Each racer will race twice, once on the inside lane, once on the outside. And the Chinese skater almost loses an edge there, but maintains his balance. Now Kim coming around the final turn on the inside. A little bit wide on the turn there, but you can see he's ahead of the first place skater currently, and so that will move him into top spot with a time of 35.64. Now by Ki Ming of China and Cha Ming Kyu of Korea. Cha set a personal best of 34.82 seconds here in Kazakhstan in Astana back in December. And there you see him under control through the final straight and to the finish line in the lead here in this first race, a time of 35.16 seconds. Now Denis Koval of Russia and Koto Nakao of Japan. Nakao's personal best came in Calgary back in 2015, a time of 34.97 seconds. And there you see Nakao just behind of that top spot pace. He will finish with a time of 35.35 seconds. Good for second spot here in this first race. There you see the leaderboard after the opening sprint. Now on to race two. Here's Palkin of Kazakhstan, and again, Kim Young-jin of Korea. Came in third spot in that opening race, needing to pick up the speed a little bit here to find a way to move up on the podium. There you see Kim ahead of the top spot pace right now. And he will cross currently in first. Time in the second race of 35.49 seconds. So slightly ahead of what he had in the first. Now back to Nakao of Japan and Ruslan Rafikov of Russia. The Japanese skater there on the inside lane to start. Had a time of 35.35 seconds in the opening race. Currently on pace to move into first, and he will, 35.40. So a little bit slower than his first race, but very consistent. Now Krikunov of Kazakhstan, and our leader after the first race, Cha Ming-kyu of Korea. Cha put down a time of 35.16 seconds, and he'll start this second race in the inside lane. Krikunov laboring there, you can see, but Cha powers through that final turn, trying to stay ahead of that pace line, and he'll do it quite easily, 35.24 seconds. And his combined time will put him in gold medal position. He put down the two best times overall, 70.40 for gold. It is the men's Nordic combined individual Gunderson from the Sunkar International Ski Jumping Complex here in Almaty. This event was postponed from January 31st, so we're a day late, but we're all set to go. Conditions have cleared just enough for the jumpers to get going. So we'll have the jump here on the Normal Hill first, and then they'll move over to do the 10-kilometer cross-country ski event later in the day. First up here is Kazuma Yamamoto of Japan. And Yamamoto, the eighth jumper to go, decent jump. He doesn't look overly happy with it. You can see his skis crossed a little bit in behind him and almost loses an edge there at the end, but 111.5 points. Now Paweł Słowiak of Poland. Decent landing. You can see he's a little frustrated too as he lost his balance a little bit after initially touching down. 93 meters, 108.8 points. Now Vyacheslav Barkov of Russia. And a really solid jump there for him. Good control through the air and a good landing. 95 meters, 114.2 points. He's temporarily in first spot. Now Tobias Simon of Germany. A good solid jump there for the German. Strong on the takeoff, controlled through the air. And a decent landing, 99.5 meters, 123.1 points. Now go Yamamoto. Japan has really dominated this event at Universiad. 7 gold, 10 silver, and 8 bronze medals all time. Yamamoto aiming to add to that here today. And a great jump by him. He'll be the only jumper on the day to go over 100 meters. 102 meters, 128.6 points. He's in first spot. Now Adam Cieslar of Poland. He is the two-time defending gold medalist in this event at Universiad. He won his first gold in 2013 in Trentino and then in Slovakia in 2015. Cieslar trying to take over from Yamamoto, who put down the best jump so far. Good solid one here for him, 114.5 points, 95.5 meters. That's good for third spot, heading into the cross-country ski. And now to the 10-kilometer race. The athletes will line up, and depending on the distance and points they earned at ski jumping, that will determine the stagger for the start. Yamamoto will start first. Simon of Germany will go second. There you see Yamamoto in bib number one. He is off. And 22 seconds behind him, there you see Tobias Simon. Cieslar 56 seconds back. There he is in bib number three. And from there, the athletes will progress out onto the course. And there is our leader, Yamamoto. Cieslar and Barkov trying to work their way closer to the Japanese athlete. There is Simon. Cieslar and Barkov right close to each other. And there you see the gap. Yamamoto still with a lead, but the pack is closing on him. And you can see shortly after, they do catch him. Come on. Bib number 8, that's David Velde of Germany, the defending silver medalist. There is Barkov as well as Chiesler. Yamamoto running out of gas. And now we head into the finish area. Barkov, Chiesler for gold. And it will be the Russian. Chiesler cannot win 3 straight gold medals, though he comes very close. And Pavel Słowiak of Poland, you see there in the bronze medal position. There are the final standings in the men's Nordic combined individual Gunderson. The women's normal hill individual competition from the Sunkar ski jumping complex here in Almaty. There you see Susanna Forstrom of Finland. And there the start list. Each athlete will get 2 jumps. And we'll take a look here at the first round. This is Marta Krepelkova of the Czech Republic. Studies at the Czech Technical University in Prague. And a good jump for her. And she will score 107.9 points on a distance of 93 meters. Now here's Forstrom. Debuted on the World Cup back in 2013 in Lillehammer. And a great jump here for the Finnish athlete. 116.9 points, 93.5 meters. She's in top spot. Now Haruka Iwasa of Japan. Was part of a team gold medal in the 2014 World Ski Jumping Championships. And a good solid jump for her, 111.5 points, 90 meters. Not enough to catch Forstrom, but she's in second spot. Now Yuka Kobayashi, also of Japan. A silver medalist in the individual normal hill in Slovakia back at Universiade in 2015. Has to work hard to hold that landing. For Kobayashi, 105 points, 91.5 meters. So there are your standings. After the first round, Susanna Forstrom with a solid lead in top spot. Back to Kobayashi. Won 2 other medals in Slovakia Universiade in 2015, in the team event and the mixed event. Her total is 200.2 points. Now Krepelkova was 3rd following the opening round. Not quite the landing she was hoping for. Good score though for her. Her total will be 198.8. She's now in second spot. Here's Haruka Iwasa. 2nd after the opening jump with a score of 111.5. Trying to put herself in position to hold off Forstrom, who still is yet to jump. And a good jump there, Iwasa, 212.6 points. She's in top spot. Now Forstrom led after the opener. Good control through the air. Oh, and then Forstrom loses an edge in the outrun and goes down. That solid jump probably would have given her the gold medal. There you see the reaction from Kobayashi and Iwasa, 188.1 points. 4th for Forstrom. Iwasa wins gold. Her Japanese teammate Yuka Kobayashi will claim silver, while Marta Krepelkova of the Czech Republic wins the bronze medal. Heartbreak for Forsstrom, who was in a good spot after that strong opening jump. And there you have the three medalists in the women's normal hill individual competition in Almaty.
Good afternoon, ladies.
From the Almaty Arena, figure skating underway. This is the women's short program here at the 28th Winter Universiade. Very large crowd on hand here to watch the short program. First up, Hinano Isobe of Japan. She will skate to the music from The Legend of 1900. And there you see her wrap her program up. And very happy with that performance, as is her coach, Yuriko Naruse. 56.78, her score. She would end up in fifth spot. Now, Elizaveta Tukhtamysheva of Russia. She won the 2015 World Championship gold medal, also won the European Championship gold that year, skating to Carmina Burana by Carl Orff. Her final element done, much to the delight of this packed house and the Russian supporters. And there's her coach, Tatiana Prokofieva, 69.01 for Tukhtamysheva. Now Elena Radionova of Russia. She finished just behind Tukhtamysheva at the 2015 World Championship, winning a silver medal. She's also a two-time World Junior gold medalist and the first woman to ever do that. Her music is from Porgy and Bess by George Gershwin. And a wonderful performance for her, 69.02. Her coach, Ina Goncharenko, cheering her on and supporting her there. Now, this is Rin Niyata of Japan. Last year competed on the ISU Junior Grand Prix Series. She's skating here to Red Violin by Akuko Kawai. And a really strong performance there for the Japanese skater, also coached by Yuriko Naruse, 61.9. Good for third place. That is a season best for her. Next up, Roberta Rodriguero of Italy. Her music is Ar Lavare by Astor Piazzolla. Solid landing on the jump. Her performance included a triple toe combination. Final element for her. Good performance there for the Italian.
She has earned in the short program
59.03, fourth place. So in solid spot heading into the free skate. And there you have the results. Radionova in first, Tukhtamysheva in second, Niyata in third, heading to the free skate.